for the purchase of high-rated pooled assets of financially sound NBFCs amounting to a total of 1 lakh crores of rupees during the current financial year, government will provide one-time 6 months partial credit guarantee to public sector banks for first loss up to 10%. Further, Reserve Bank of India is the regulator of the NBFCs. However, RBI has limited regulatory authority over NBFCs. Appropriate proposals for strengthening the regulatory authority of RBI over NBFCs are being placed in the finance bill. NBFCs, which do public placement of debt, have to maintain a debenture redemption reserve. And in addition, a special reserve as required by RBI has also to be maintained. To allow NBFCs to raise funds in public issues, the requirement of creating a DRR, that is a debenture redemption reserve, which is currently applicable for only public issues as private placements are exempt, this will be done away with. To bring more participants, especially NBFCs, not registered as NBFCs factor, on the TREDS platform, amendment in the Factoring Regulation Act 2011 is necessary and steps will be taken to allow all NBFCs to directly participate on the TREDS platform. Efficient and conducive regulation of the housing sector is extremely important in our context. The National Housing Bank, besides being a refinancer and a lender, is also the regulator of the housing finance sector. This gives a somewhat conflicting and difficult mandate to the NHB. I am proposing to return the regulation authority over the housing finance sector from the NHB, National Housing Board, to the RBI. I am proposing to return the regulation authority over the housing finance sector from NHB to the RBI. Necessary proposals have been placed in the finance bill even for that. Government has announced its intention to invest 100 lakh crores in infrastructure over the next 5 years. 100 lakh crores for infrastructure over the next 5 years. To this end, it is proposed to set up an expert committee to study the current situation relating to long-term finance and a past experience with development finance institutions, and this committee shall recommend the structure and required flow of funds through development finance institutions. The situation will be reviewed by them and they will suggest measures. Pension Fund Regulatory Development Authority, PFRDA, implements and regulates the national pension system, the NPS and Atal Pension Yojana, through various intermediaries, including, inter alia, the NPS Trust. Keeping in view the wider interest of the subscribers and to maintain arm's length relationship of the NPS Trust with PFRDA, steps will be taken to separate the NPS Trust from PFRDA with appropriate organizational structure. To facilitate onshoring of international insurance transactions, and to enable opening of branches by foreign reinsurers in the International Financial Service Center, it is proposed to reduce net owned fund requirement from 5,000 crores to 1,000 crores. I'll repeat that sentence, sir. To facilitate onshoring of international insurance transactions, and to enable opening of branches by foreign reinsurers in the International Financial Services Center, it is proposed to reduce net owned fund requirement from 5,000 crores to 1,000 crores. Government has been following the policy of disinvestment in non-financial public sector undertakings, maintaining government stake not to go below 51%. Government is considering, in case where the undertaking is still to be retained in government control, to go below 51% to an appropriate level on case-to-case basis. Government has also decided to modify present policy of retaining 51% government stake to retaining 51% stake inclusive of the stake of government-controlled institutions. Sir Speaker, in order to improve the capital flows into the Indian economy, it is important to align domestic corporate systems and practices with global ones. It is also appreciated that global finance movement in equity uses certain parameters to evaluate the stocks in which they choose to invest. The government intends to further encourage retail participation in CPSEs, which of late has shown very encouraging upward trend. In order to provide additional investment space, the government would realign its holding in CPSEs, including banks, to permit greater availability of its shares and to improve depth of its market. Strategic disinvestment of select CPSEs would continue to remain a priority of this government. In view of current macroeconomic parameters, government would not only reinitiate the process of strategic disinvestment of Air India, but would offer more CPSEs for strategic participation by the private sector. I repeat this sentence: strategic disinvestment of select CPSEs would continue to remain a priority for this government. In view of current macroeconomic parameters, government would not only reinitiate the process of strategic disinvestment of Air India, but also would offer more CPSEs for strategic participation by the private sector. Government is setting an enhanced target of ₹1,05,000 crore of disinvestment receipts for the financial year 2019-20.